This is the Ecoflow app for the Ecoflow Blade. As we can see up at the top, if I select the blade, it will Bluetooth over to my blade, or if I happen to be remote and it's connected to Wi-Fi, it will connect that way. There you saw, connecting to Bluetooth. Right there you can see that icon changes. That lets you know that you are connected via Bluetooth and not Wi-Fi. To the right of that, you will see an indicator that's letting you know the GPS signal strength for it. Moving on, we have this cloud sync. Selecting that will allow you to, if you have not already set up a Wi-Fi network, will allow you to set one up. Now I'm gonna go back since I already have one set up and I don't wanna disturb that. On our main screen here, we can see this is the outline of what I've already done. I have two red spots. Those red spots are the no-go zones. Over here is the total square footage. I can zoom in or out on the map. There's a little icon there where the charging base is and where the mower actually is. If it happens to be out doing what it needs to do, you will see that there will be white lines for things that it has already gone through, letting you know exactly where it is mowed. Underneath the name of it right there, Rover, because, you know, I'm clever, just like about 100 other people who thought it looked like a lunar rover. There is your power indicator. Right now, green indicates that it is charging, and it does state charging next to that. That green number is very important because you want to see green, because that does actually let you know that it is charging. Down here at the bottom, we have overall. That's what we're kind of looking at right now. We could do a selected area. So if I happen to have divided this particular spot into two, I can select which one of my areas I would like to do and then hit start and send the robot out on its way to start mowing. Grayed out is end or home. So if you send it out and you want to bring it back prematurely, you simply select that and it will bring the robot back to the charging base. Over here, we have two icons. The first being if I select it right here, this is going to be our automations. I have two automations that I have set up and then one automation that was already there, but I'm not going to turn on. And this is the stop work time between. I have a mow on Monday and Wednesdays for a specific time. So if I bring that open here, I could see it starts at 1600 and then does this weekly and then start work. So I can select this and say, what do I want this to do? I can select the mow mode. I can select the cutting height overall, meaning everything, or I could select a specific area. So you can get very granular with the things that you set up. Or if you have one day a week where you have a slightly different, and in my case, everything's the same, except I lower it just a little bit because I don't want this running on the weekend when I'm around, so I make the cut a little lower. But if I needed to add a new day or a new automation, I simply come up here to the upper right hand corner, select the plus sign, and I can select a new time to work and then a stop time. The one thing that I wish they would allow you to do is change this so that you could have something other than military time. Not everybody is familiar with military time, so a standard 12-hour day would be nice to see. Down here, we have our settings for the mower, the quick settings. These are, if I push the button to send it out, what is that going to do? So again, we have our speeds and then our cutting height. Speeds, and I wish this was a little more descriptive, gentle, normal, and quick. That really is the progression or the speed that the robot will move while it's cutting. Not gentle cut, normal cut, quick cut. Speed of which the robot moves. That dialogue needs a little work. In the upper right-hand corner, these are all the settings that we can do. This was just controls and navigation for the mower. Selecting our settings right up here, we have our name. So here's Rover. That by default will be the serial number for your particular device. Here we have device sharing. I can add somebody who I'd like to share control of the robot with. Now, in this case, I'm not going to do that, but they would need their own Ecoflow app in order to do so. You would just send them an email. About's going to give you serial numbers, all the important information that you wouldn't show in a YouTube video. So that's going to be what that is. Work record. This is going to show you the amount of times that the robot has gone out and the average of what it did. The one thing I wish they would improve in this area is if I clicked on one of these, I wish it would show me the map, show me what it actually did. This way, instead of just relying on square footage, I can say, okay, it did section one versus section two, and I can see that visually here. So it's there, it's not great. Here we have our automation. I showed you that a little bit before, but this is just another way that you can get to it. Right here, you can see the automations. I'm gonna back up. Here we have our work preferences. So right here, rain delay. Well, do you want to have a rain delay, meaning if the robot's out and it senses that there's water, what does it do? In my case, I turned it on and then I said, after returning to home, wait 29 minutes before going out and completing the job. Now, you can do all the way up to 23 hours and 59 minutes, meaning you can have it wait an entire day before it goes out and does it again. So this is rather customizable. I do like that. And then coming back, we have our edge work. So one, do you want it to do edge work? So yes or no. Working edge lap. So after it finishes cutting, how many times do you want it to take a lap around your edge? And then here you have, how high do you want the edge to cut? You can have that lower, higher, whatever you'd like. like, and then when that goes out, it does it. It does not appear to do if you set it up on a routine. The routine is it goes out, it cuts. Even if you press the button and send it out, and it will do the edge work after it does the primary cut. Routine, it looks like you have to schedule that separately. Might change in the future depending on what they do with the app. Here we have manual controls. This will allow you to undock the robot and move it around if you wanted to. So here, the joystick that you had when you originally mapped everything. I wish that was a little different. Here we have map management. Here is the one map I had. You can see I can add a zone from here, but I cannot edit a pre-existing no-go zone or add another no-go zone. I would have to reset and remap everything if I wanted to do that. I can do add a zone without having to do that, but hopefully by the time you're seeing this in the far future, they fix this, because this is one of the biggest things that I know myself and other people have complained about. Coming down, we have firmware. Just as it sounds, this will show you what your firmware is looking like. If you have it connected to Wi-Fi, it can download that over the Wi-Fi signal, or if you don't, you'd have to download to the phone first and then Bluetooth it over, meaning you have to keep the phone within proximity. Here you have help and feedback. As it sounds, here's a whole bunch of information that you have about your Ecoflow Blade, all done digitally. Helps keep the paperwork down. Mower settings. Here we have master volume. This is going to be those audio prompts that you get from the robot itself. Mower lighting. This will, as it sounds, turn on and off the lights, which is useful if you don't want it sticking out like a sore thumb in the middle of your yard in the complete darkness. I wish that they had moved this somewhere else, because before I started digging through all of the options, the first thing I thought of is like, well, I wish I could turn the lights off. Well, you can. It's just buried in two submenus. Child safety lock. This will prevent the robot from being restarted if tampered with or picked up by pushing the two buttons on the robot itself. It will require the application in order to unlock it and restart it. And here we have account binding reset and factory reset. Just like they sound, it will reset your device. Here we have unit length, US or metric. And then here we have find mower. Right now I zoomed into where it is because I don't necessarily want to show where that is, but you can see directions. It's 83 feet from my current location, and I can mark as lost. If I select directions, I can go into Google Map and it will direct me exactly there. Mark as lost will lock the thing down and nobody can do anything with it when it's locked down. And then I can unlink from my account. Not gonna be doing that, but just as it sounds, it will remove this mower from your account so that you can give it to somebody else or get a new mower or have more than one. But that is currently everything that you can do with the Ecoflow app for the Ecoflow Blade. It is a very bare bones application. I do wish that they made this one a little more functional and feature rich. What do I mean by that? Well, this up here, this is just letting you know, hey, it's got good satellite signal. There's other robots out there that let you know exactly how many satellites it's connected to. I wish they would do something like that. It's a good start, and I know it will improve because a lot of the gripes that I have with it right now are software based, and that means that they can update it by updating the application.